We were talking about literature, great books. What's the best book you ever read?
Best book I ever read.
So many.
You know, I really don't know how to answer that question.
Yeah, it's hard. It's like, yeah, it's almost impossible. Yeah, I don't know if I could answer.
It would have to be something I read as a kid that was probably bullshit. You know, I've been thinking about a lot lately.
Yeah.
The White Mountains books.
I never read that. What is that?
It's like just some War of the Worlds kind of bullshit. Can I hit that? Thanks. It's like it's about these boys, and basically the Earth's been like colonized by these big like tripod aliens, like in War of the Worlds.
Mm-hmm.
These big tripod aliens, and on your 13th birthday, they like they like abduct you, and they do this thing called capping.
Bar mitzvah.
It's a bar mitzvah, basically.
Yeah.
But it's this like mesh metal cap that goes like onto your skull bone, and then it can like control your thoughts or whatever.
Yeah.
And then it's like this kid's capping is coming up, and he doesn't want to do it. So him and his three friends run away, and they're on the run from these fucking aliens, basically.
Mm-hmm.
But I remember reading that when I was a kid.
That was a series of books.
There were three of them.
Is that where the term capping comes from?
Yeah, no
amongst
cap.
Youth culture.
But I don't know. You remember how it was when you were a kid, and you'd have even like the assigned summer reading.
I remember when I read Cat's Cradle. I was like, books can be really cool.
Yeah, but
I found out about Vonnegut when I was a kid. I was like, wow, this guy's doing something different.
Even reading something like books used to be so immersive.
Yeah,
you know, I could like really get into them.
Yeah,
and now it only kind of works. I'm never fully, like, just gone.
The last book I read that was, like, that I was, like, felt like that, where I was like, damn, is, I read Penin, like, I think end of last year, beginning of this year, the Nabokov book, and that guy is fucking amazing. But it's like, the thing I like about his books is that they're a bit. He's doing a bit, you know?
Yeah, because I mean, I've only ever read Lolita, but I've, like, felt that it was very, like, technically masterful, you know? Like, he's obviously a very good writer.
They say he had synesthesia, so they say that like basically every word is kind of, which I don't know, I don't think that's a real thing. I think it's
a lie. That's what I mean, it's like that you can get an aesthetic appreciation out of it.
Yeah, but every word is very deliberate.
Sure.
And I didn't realize the first time I read Lolita that he was writing it in English. I was like, his mastery of language, but like, you know, like when you watch a foreign film, right? And then like, what's his name? Wong Kar-wai made an English language movie, and it was dog shit.
Yeah, well, he doesn't speak English.
Exactly, right? So but you watch like a French movie.
It's like, oh, how I go bathroom.
Well, yeah,
I'm in love with the bathroom.
It was about eating pie or something. My Blueberry Nights. Have you seen it? It's doo-doo, right?
Pooh-berry Nights.
Yeah, My Pooh-berry Nights, yeah. And it was with Nora Jones.
Yeah. I'll be honest, his movies don't really do anything for me.
I like Chungking Express.
Yeah.
I guess. I like the gay one. Happy Together, that one's good.
Yeah, I don't know.
Mood for Love is boring. Whatever. He's not my favorite. But what I'm saying is when you watch
they're very slick.
You watch a movie in a foreign language, you can't really tell if the guy's acting well, right? You're like, oh, if he was in English, if he was saying all this crap in English, then I would be evaluating it in a different way. So for me to find out that Nabokov was writing it in English, because I heard he had a Russian name, I was like, oh, this is like Tolstoy or something. Mm. Then I like went back and had an appreciation for like his placement of words. No, and stuff.
I understood he wrote in English because he's not really included in like the Russians when you talk.
No, no, he was American. Right. I mean, well, he wasn't American. He was from there, but he wrote in English.
Yeah,
Panin's really good. You should read it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, did you read it though, or you listened to it?
I read that actually.
Yeah.
I read that on paper.
Because that's the other thing with audiobooks. I don't feel like it would be as immersive.
Sometimes you don't like the guy's voice.
Yeah.
But for me, it's like if I'm going through an airport or something and I'm on the road, or if I'm alone and I'm walking through a city, I'm going to go get the taco that you're supposed to get in that city, then I'll just have something playing because I just need some stimulation.
Mm-hmm.